It is said health and self-care are so important. When you take time to replenish your spirit, it allows you to serve others from the overflow. You cannot serve from an empty vessel. With these few words, I'm here to inform you that I am back. I must say I am rejuvenated and ready to serve you from the overflow. I'd like to thank all those who have made this possible. May the good Lord bless and keep you. Amen. Dear friends, I've returned to meet a broken flock returning from the exile of COVID-19, a hopeless remnant like those mentioned in the first reading of today. Hopeless because many have lost their loved ones to COVID-19. Some unfortunately have stopped hoping. Some think they don't have the right to dream again. You can imagine a pregnant woman without a husband. You can imagine a child without father and mother. Who will provide for them? This happened to be a familiar story or situation the Israelites found themselves. Many have lost their husbands because of war. Pregnant women are left without their husbands due to war. Some are wounded. So we can put all these people into a category of a blind, weak, feeble, and poor nation without vision or dreams. Basically, the best person who can define their state is the blind and poor Bartimaeus in the gospel reading of today. A poor blind man without a dream or vision. He always depends on others for survival. Such a broken nation needs much more to stand on their feet. But guess what they were given today? Hope. The prophet Jeremiah is noted for prophesying doom to his people. But today he was sent to give consolation, hope to the remnants. My message for you today is one, be hopeful. Yesterday is gone, another day has come. God is opening a new door, a door of possibilities. Let the psalm of today, Psalm 126, be your own psalm. May your mouth be filled with laughter. Amen. 2. Trust in the Lord with unwavering faith. And the question is, why should you? Because the only high priest who understands your weakness is the Lord. He understands the predicament of Bartimaeus and offered him a breakthrough. He's ready to do it for you. What you need to do is to trust in him. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. 3. Where is your faith in the storm of life? People actually challenged the faith of Bartimaeus, but he did not give up. Would your anchor hold in the storm of life? They reminded Bartimaeus of his state, but he shouted all the more, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." When your faith is challenged, do you give up? 4. There are some people who are comfortable with your discomfort. I've realized that in life, there are some people who are comfortable with our discomfort. When Bartimaeus was shouting for help, they asked him to keep quiet. They were comfortable with his state. Are you one of those people? If you're one of those people, let go of your old way of life. 5. Remember, in life, there are some people who will not give you the reason to take a step that will lead you to your progress, to your freedom. Beware of those people. We pray, dear friend, may those who give us a reason not to take a step that will lead to our freedom, to our progress, be brought to shame. Amen. 6. Remember, some friends are bullies. They are only good at amplifying our weaknesses. Are you one of those friends? There are some friends who never ever amplify our potentials, what we are good at, applaud us. They are always there to tell us that we cannot make it, that we are not good enough. Today we've seen them in a gospel reading. They were telling Bartimaeus, "But you are blind, you cannot go. Keep quiet," when he was shouting for help. They were reminding him of his state of being. And there are some friends like that. Dear friends, let us give people the reason to live again like Jesus Christ. Are you a victim of the crowd? Then shout when you are asked to be silent. Never give up. Jesus, Son of David, the Messiah, is ready to give you new insight. Is ready to give you a second chance. All you need to do is to shout, to approach him and call him, and he is there to attend to your needs. Don't give up. Have faith, and may your faith grant you your heart's desire according to the will of God. Amen. God bless you.
Next time.